is the Shop Hop edition. Woo! I think I'm going to start subtitling all the
episodes. That would make it easier.
Yeah, I think we should.
Just number 25 or whatever.
I think it's number 26, but yeah, I don't know for sure.
Number 26. Okay. Last time was number 25.
So, we're posting this on the first day of the Shop Hop. We're not filming this on the first day of the Shop Hop, because if we were, we would not be sitting here calmly in front of you.
No, we would be in panic mode, running around like chickens with their heads cut off.
Yeah. Yeah, Shop Hop is always interesting.
That's the word.
Cecilia just dropped a stitch marker, I think.
Oh, I did.
Yeah. So anyway, we're going to show you all of our Shop Hop stuff today. We're going to show you some other products that we have in the store. And yeah.
Yeah.
So, first, I guess,
April.
We're actually filming this on April Fool's Day, but we don't have any April Fool's for you. Oh, that's what we didn't bring out here.
Our April Fool?
The knitted wit color for the month.
No, not
even
get it.
Uh-huh. You're closer than me, and I'm,
And you're not doing anything.
Exactly.
Because
I'm the boss, and I get to tell her what to do. So anyway, while she's doing that, I'll tell you what I'm knitting. I am working on a little sweater. I can't remember the name of it. I will find out what the name is and I'll let you know. I'll put it in the top.
Flower shop.
Oh yeah, something like flower shop. Yeah. Anyway, I'm making it out of unique fingering. This is one side of it. Sorry, I've got a piece of string in there, so I can't hold the whole thing up, but it's just a boxy t-shirt kind of thing. I love the way it stripes, although the color's not coming out great on the camera. Maybe it'll look better when I look at it on
the playback?
Yeah, on the actual video. But it's interesting because it's garter stitch with some eyelet rows, but the way she's written it, you have to purl every row, except for the eyelet rows, which is kind of annoying. And
that's
horrible. Yeah, and I really thought, well, I'll change it to knit every row. But in order to do that, you then have to change the eyelet rows to purl rows. And they're two different eyelet rows, one with a, she does a slip knit, pass a slip stitch over, and then a K2 together row. And so you'd have to, the K2 together row is not hard to figure out. I mean, it'd be a purl two together row. And I just didn't want to spend the time figuring out. And I didn't know if I was going to display it in the shop at all. So if we display it in the shop and I totally rewrite the pattern, then
it's a problem.
Yeah, then it's a problem. So
I'm
just purling.
Problem.
Doing a lot of purling. Actually not minding it too much. I thought I would mind it more than I am. So, but I do like the way it's turning out. I'm hoping to have this done before Yarn Over so I can, I don't know. I might want to wear this fabulous t-shirt that we're wearing at Yarn Over. So these are our Minnesota Knit t-shirts.
Yes.
You can't see it on the bottom of mine, but you can see it on the bottom of Cecilia's. Minnesota Knit. So, yeah.
Yep.
We got these for Shop Hop.
Yep.
You know, I'll just show this too, that we got these little enamel pins for Shop Hop. These are specially made.
They're
Minnesota
fabulous.
Knit little enamel pins.
It's a landscape.
Cecilia's husband designed the graphic for both the t-shirt and the pin. He did the landscape coloring on this as well. So we're very excited about those. Those both t-shirts and enamel pens are available on our website or in the store.
Yeah, you can order ahead of time and just pick them up.
Yes, if you're coming. Well, except they can't because this won't be posted until.
Oh, sorry.
Shop Hop Day, so.
Well,
yeah. You could
order it now and then come pick it up
during Shop Hop.
During a couple days afterwards. If you come on Saturday.
Right.
If you order on Thursday, you come on Saturday.
And here's the deal with both of them. I mean, we have limited quantities. The t-shirts come in ladies' sizes and unisex sizes. We have limited quantities of each of the sizes in those two styles.
Mm-hmm.
But if we run out, we'll just take special orders and order more. So
yeah.
You can can order online, and if we run out, we'll let you know, and we'll let you know when they're going to come in. They're the t-shirts in particular are very quick. I mean, within 2 weeks, we have them in.
Yeah.
The enamel pens take a little bit longer, but not very long. 3 weeks, maybe?
Yeah.
So,
can I talk about what I'm working on?
Yes.
I'm still working on this stupid sweater. So, if you recall, I was further along on this sleeve last time I was here. And then the next day I was digging through my bag of needles and I found a 9-inch US 9. I'm like, do I have two of these? What? I didn't think I had two of these. Because I know I'm using the one in my sweater because that's the correct size. No, I don't have two of them. I have one. And it was in my bag, not in my sweater. So it had to be ripped out.
Is it for your cuffs, the smaller size?
Yes.
That happens.
Yes.
Oh, man.
Yes. So I just stopped I got done my ribbing, and I'm like, oh, it's an 8. I just, grabbed it out of the thing. And
here's the thing. If that happened to me, that sweater might have to sit in timeout for a while.
Yeah. I would like to time out this one, too, except for, it needs to be here. So, I'm working on this. But then I'm working on another project because my June cashmere knit along started. And I can't work on this while I'm here because it's
fussy.
It's a complicated ribbing thing. It's not just ribbing. It's, here in this part we're going to have you do 3. In this part we're going to have you do 2. And so this is how far I've gotten. And
so what's that project called?
This is called...
Hey, did you steal that little post-it note from me?
Mm-hmm.
I had a bunch of those on my desk for a long time. I know we have more of them here in the store. I'm just teasing.
I didn't have my posties with me. So,
they're special post-it notes. They have little shoes and shopping bags on them or something.
Yes.
I don't know.
It's not me.
I don't know why they're...
I wouldn't.
Oh, it's a tele vest that you're making.
Yes, the tele vest from June Cashmere. And... so obviously when I get the little lacy bits, someday I might get there. That's why you have
the different ribbing
sizes.
Yeah.
But
do you have lots of stitch markers to show you when you get to the different ribs and stuff?
Well, at this point, I've got 4 or 5 or however many there are. But we've started, but you can still start because it's just a knit along. So if you have some June cashmere project you want to start on, you've got a class, we meet again this Wednesday. You can come join us. It's every other week on Wednesdays. And then I have this thing that I found.
No, wait a minute. The June cashmere knit along is free, but we'd like you to sign up if possible.
Yes, sign up.
Because
so
we know who's coming.
Yeah,
so
the store's closed, so you can't just show up.
Yeah.
It's at
6 to 8 p.m.
Yeah. And then the other thing is, so I was rooting around somewhere trying to, on my shelves, looking for something else. And I came across this hat. Look at this cute hat, right? I'm like, I wonder when I made that hat. And then I wonder why it's sitting here on this shelf. And I discovered this. Do you see that? I made this hat years ago, and I never wove in the ends, so I put it on a shelf? I don't know what I do. So anyway, I just want people to know that we all have stuff where it's like, what? Why wouldn't I just do that? I don't even mind weaving in ends. So I don't know why I didn't do it, but it's on my to-do list now. So now I've got 3 things I'm working on right now. Shame would be for Clint.
Yes, I've got 4 things I'm working on right now. Yeah, but I really want to get this one done.
Yes.
So this one's kind of taking precedent. And then I have a Malabrigo little sweater that I really want to get done too, which I really am not working on yet. I just finished the swatch last night.
Yeah.
But I got to finish that strength and trick.
Yeah.
I just really have to do that. I have to buckle down and force myself to do it because I'm not at the most interesting part. Projects are always most exciting when you first start them.
They really are.
Yeah.
This is true.
Or when you finish them and can
use them.
Yes, that's exciting too.
Yeah.
Or give them to whoever they belong to. Sometimes it's exciting.
True. All right, so.
So there's that yarn.
Oh, you want to show that yarn while we finish up this row, and then we'll show the shop hop yarn.
Okay. This is the Knitted Witch Yarn of the Month.
Sassy Holidays Club.
Sassy Holidays, and it's called Pumpkin Spice Latte. What? April Fools! So, yes, that is her colorway.
We opened it up. We opened the box up, and we were like, she put the wrong labels on this. This is wrong. Because we had, she sends out a love letter, what she calls a love letter, to the stores who are part of her club each month, and she sent out a love letter, and I had not read it. And the love letter said, hey, it's April Fool's Day, that's what we're celebrating this month. We're sending out this color, it's called Pumpkin Spice Latte, but it doesn't look like that because it's April Fool's. But we were so stumped when we opened up that box.
Well, I think it's a very fun color. So
it is, it's great. But not looking like pumpkin spice latte.
That's actually, if you color. Had this pumpkin spice latte sitting around until now, it might look like that. So maybe that's what she's going for. You know.
We have had mold colorways before.
We have various things.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, so I did not finish my row, but I'm going to put it down for a little bit. I'm going to show you the shop hop yarns, and I'm going to show you the shop hop project. So, we work with Polka Dot Sheep, whom we love. They're out of Montana, and they developed two special colorways for us in their Tenderfoot 8020, which is a fingering weight yarn. So here's the first one. Oh, by the way, the Shop Hop theme this year is inspired by games, and our game is the Mystery Date Game.
Mystery Date Game, yay!
And we all played it as children.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a boy, you probably didn't play it, but maybe, I don't know.
Good.
Doesn't matter, it's just a competition.
Yeah.
You know.
But if you don't know the game, the idea is that you're going around the board putting together outfits for different dates. And you pick which date you think you're going to get, right?
Yeah, once you get that whole outfit together and you land in a space where you can open the door, you have to choose from your outfits you might have gathered. You might only have one. And hope that your little skiing outfit is going to go with the guy who's behind the door. Just like in real life.
Yeah, just like in real life. Because, you know, you never know what kind of date they're going to take you on, right?
This is true. And you never know if you're going to get the skiing guy or the beach guy. And sometimes you're stuck with the beach guy. And you're like, dang, you need to go.
So your choices are a beach date, a ski date, a bowling date, a formal
date,
or a dud date.
Dud date.
Poor dud guy.
Yeah. And you just lose your whole outfit.
Anyway, so this colorway is called Mystery Door. Yeah. It's a beautiful blue with some speckly things in it and some greens. And the other colorway is called Five Dates, and it's this kind of, this one's really pretty. It's got a lot of subtle colors in it. It's kind of a gray base with some purples and some greens. Really pretty.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so we did two patterns for Shop Hop this year. We did a knit pattern and a crochet pattern. I'll show you the crochet one first. This one is by, it's called Date Night Cowl, and it's designed by Shelly Pabst.
It's fabulous.
This is the, so one of the things is for each of the mystery dates, we have a little mini skein to add to one of these colors, the special colors that we had done. So we have five different date skeins, basically. So this is the five dates colorway with the Tupelo Honey mini skein, and the cowl is called Date Night Cowl. It's a crocheted Mobius.
It's fabulous.
So it's hard for me to do this, but you can see how it twists there. I'm trying not to have the jingle bell jingle too much. We put jingle bells on our samples because, yes, they do walk out the door.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully this will stop people, or we will hear people taking them. But if you don't know what a Mobius is, it's a continuous strip. We may have done this before in the podcast, but if you start here and you follow the outside of the Mobius, oops, I messed up. Outside of the Mobius, it goes around here, comes up here, and goes back around here, and then you get here. But you've got a half twist in it. So it's kind of cool. We will have, or we do have a video on our YouTube channel to help you construct your Mobius if the written instructions aren't good enough for you. So there's that. I also wanted to show you guys the prototypes that we had before we had the samples done, because they're kind of fun too. So I crocheted the sample for Shop Hop, but Shelley, when she was designing it, crocheted this one. This is a different Polka Dot Sheep Tenderfoot 8020 colorway with a Lorna's Lace Staccato mini skein for the contrast, but it's pretty. Hers is a little looser than mine. I mean, I did it to the gauge that she suggested, but I think she blocked hers much
more aggressively.
I mean, I blocked mine as aggressively as I could, but her chain was a lot looser. So her foundation chain was a lot looser than mine. So we put in the instructions to, after I had finished mine, we changed the instructions to say chain very loosely, because you know, with this one, I just couldn't go any wider.
Mm-hmm.
It's, you know, that's it.
Yeah.
And Shelley's, she was able to do wider.
So, I don't know anything about crochet. Would it help if you did it on a bigger crochet hook, like in knitting, or I don't, does that?
I mean, it could help. You know, the way I do my crochet chain is I always do it around a knitting needle, so because it's easier for me to figure out where to insert my hook into the chain when I'm doing my first row then.
Okay.
So could I have put it around a bigger knitting needle? Maybe. I don't know when you're actually just doing a chain, not around a knitting needle. I think using a bigger hook doesn't make that big of a difference, because when you pull it through, there's nothing
there
to hold that gap, right?
Okay.
Or that circle.
All right.
But Shelley says she's just learned to chain loosely. So I don't know. I'm kind of a half-ass crocheter. I'll just admit it. I mean, I've done it before. I've designed things in crochet. I just don't do it often enough to know all the details. So. So that's the crochet pattern, and then the knit pattern is one that I designed. This is called the Mystery Date Hat. So
there
you go. It's a contrast color is spinel. So the contrast colors are just polka dot sheep regular colors. The main colors are our exclusive colors for the Shop Hop. But this is a slip stitch. A slip twist stitch pattern that I kind of made up for the hat. And what we found is that this hat is a little small. I mean, for my daughter's head, it would fit fine. For our mannequin heads here, it fits fine. So we made the pattern with three different sizes, this small size, a medium, and a large. It's a 12-stitch repeat, so you could make it even larger if you wanted to. So that's the Shop Hop colorways, and then this is my prototype that I did in another polka dot sheep yarn.
If they make it in the largest size, will they have enough mini skein?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, they'll have plenty.
Okay.
And then I think this yarn, I don't remember what I used for the contrast colors. Either Lorna's Lace's Staccato mini skein, or I just used something that I had in my stash at home. I don't remember. Yeah, it was just a prototype. So I don't know that it'll ever be displayed here, but I thought you guys might like to see it, even if we don't display it here.
Yeah.
Then what I did, because I wanted people to know how our various mini skeins looked with the main colors is I knit up these little samples. And no, they are not fingerless mitts. There are no holes for thumbs in them. So, yeah, there you go. Although, you could make one of these and put a little thumb hole in there, I suppose. But, so we've got all the different colorways. We've got the Tupelo Honey. We've got, just trying to remember the names of these colorways.
This one's Whiskey Creek.
No,
my favorite.
Yeah, Whiskey Creek. This one's Spinel. This one's Meadow, maybe. This one's the one that doesn't show up the best. It's, let's put it this way. It's not that it doesn't show up the best. It's more subtle.
It's the subtler one.
And then I don't remember what this one's name is. But it's like a navy. So there's that one, and here's on the other yarn. So I think it's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
I know somebody's going to say, oh, well, can't you write that up as a pattern?
No.
Maybe. I mean, really, it's just 60 stitches, the same stitch repeat as in the hat pattern with no decreases. And, I mean, you could just, if you could just figure out how to make a thumb, it'd be fine.
Or just make it a lot shorter and then or make it more than 60 stitches. Or
I mean, it is a little tight at 60 stitches.
Mm-hmm. I would probably be 72. But once you figured out what your gauge was.
I mean, 72 might be too much,
mm-hmm.
though. I don't know. I mean, I think if you had the thumb hole, it wouldn't be too bad. Because it's really tight because my thumb's in there. So if you had a thumb hole and then made a little gusset of some kind, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Or just a thumb hole and just have your thumb sticking out. That'd be
mm-hmm.
okay too.
Yeah. That's what you want.
So anyway, that's our Shop Hop stuff.
Yay, Shop Hop.
I hope you guys like it. I like it. I am happy
mm-hmm.
with what we came up with this year.
Yes.
I have to admit, last year I was not completely happy with what we had.
Yeah, I loved that yarn.
Yeah.
I'm crazy.
You know, I didn't dislike the yarn. I love the pattern that I came up with. Yeah, it was okay. Yeah.
I don't know.
I like this better. Let's put it that way. Next year, I'll probably like whatever I do next year for the knit pattern better than what I did this year. Maybe. Maybe not.
Who knows?
I don't know. I think the best year so far, from my personal standpoint, was the year we did the Gustav Klimt stuff.
Really?
Yeah. I like the cowl, the crocheted cowl. I'm trying to remember what we did for the knit project.
I don't remember. Wasn't it something with a tree on it?
Oh, it was the fingerless mitts.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, those the people like that too.
I actually liked the year we had the Northwoods theme.
Oh, yeah, that one was good too.
I did that hat,
yep.
which was awesome.
Yeah.
And then that, you did the Tunisian towel.
Yeah, that was
awesome.
Good too. Yeah.
That was a good year. This is a good year too.
Yeah. Absolutely. Speaking of polka dot sheep, though, we do have another new polka dot sheep yarn in the store. We have Stumptown DK. Here's some of the colors of that. We really needed a hand-dyed DK yarn in the store, so we got Stumptown, which is 100% superwash merino. These are a few of the colors that we have. We mostly went with tonal colors, but, you know, if and when we reorder, we can order some multis or speckles or whatever, anything in her color line. I bet you she'd even do our colorways.
Mm.
Yeah, that could be fun.
Nice.
What else do we have? We also had Daisy Girl make up some special bags for us. And I just brought a few of them out. I didn't bring them all. Daisy Girl bags are my favorite. I mean, I have one right here. This is what my project's in. I love it that you can see, you know, your project inside. You could put your pattern right. It's hard to do this. Well, you kind of get the idea. You could put your pattern there so you could see it, right? Anyway, we normally pick our own fabric for Daisy Girl to use because we want all of her bags that we have in store to be unique to our store.
Yes.
So this one is, I love this one. This was Shane's idea.
It's fabulous.
Chicken fabric with chicken wire on the inside. It's hilarious. I love tongue-in-cheek stuff.
Yeah.
I just love it.
And chickens, who doesn't love
chickens?
Yeah.
Then because we were doing, it's inspired by games, we thought we'd do this one, which looks like Candyland.
It does.
And then I found this really pretty fabric on Spoonflower, so we had some bags made out of that.
Gorgeous.
And then in the needlepoint department here, we have a wholesale canvas line. We work with a couple of different artists, but our newest artist is from the Twin Cities, and well, I don't know if she's from the Twin Cities, but she's from Minnesota, and her name is Cindy Lindgren. She does artwork, and then she transfers her artwork on to greeting cards, and then she has a whole line on Spoonflower fabrics. So we've got a couple of her fabrics. So this is little dollar horses, and it doesn't matter. It's just so cute. And we have a couple of canvases with the doll horses on it, or at least one, maybe two. Then she has this poppies fabric. I love the inner fabric that Daisy Girl chose for this one as well. So, and this size is exclusive to our store as well.
Yes.
I asked Daisy Girl if she could make bigger bags for us so you could fit a whole sweater's worth
yes.
of project into a bag, and sure enough. And you know how I told you that probably Michelle would come while we were taping? She's here. Anyway, so I'll let Cecilia talk about, I'll get that,
okay.
And you talk about the next thing.
All right.
Excuse me.
So, one of the things we just got in is this, it's 100% Pima cotton. It's called Concentric Cotton. And it is from Haiku. And see, it's cotton in the little hole. See, it looks like a little heart. And we got this in for summer stuff. So if you want to make a summer shawl, that'd be awesome. You know, it has a lot of yardage. It has 929 yards. So you can make a ginormous shawl. But the reason we got it is because I am going to knit a little t-shirt, sweater.
I think it's a Heidi Kermeyer.
Yes, it is.
Can't remember what it's
is.
Called, but it's cute.
Something.
And I think
short.
That takes two.
Yes.
So you would alternate. I mean, you would do two rows of from one ball and two rows from the other ball, so you still get that
yeah.
cool gradient. Yeah.
Yep. So, but it'll be this color.
Has Cecilia in purple. All yarn looks better in purple,
all
according
yarn
to
looks
Cecilia.
Better in purple.
According to me, it's all yarn looks better in blue or green.
Well, everyone's got their thing. The other day, Serena said I look very good in purple, so bleh.
Well, maybe that's why you like it. Maybe I like blue and green because I look good in blue and green. I don't know.
Could be. Or maybe because we like it, we look good in it. That's my theory.
Yeah.
That if you like a color, it's going to look
nature
good
versus nurture.
Yes. It makes you happy to wear it.
Yeah.
So that is what we got. And I'm very excited to start that. But I need to finish this first. So, you know, knit, knit, knit.
Chop, chop.
And this is our project.
Perk project
for April. It is made out of Andorra from our friends at Kelborn Woolens. So here's the yarn. Merino.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
I picked it up.
You
it's
could,
sport weight.
Yes.
And the cardigan is called Winterfell.
Yes.
And we picked it because this month the last season of Game of Thrones starts on Netflix. So
yes.
It just seemed appropriate.
I believe winter is finally here in the show.
Yeah, I mean,
and
it'd be really funny if this color was called snow.
I don't think it is.
That'd be really funny. Hold on, I'm going to find out. Snow White, close enough.
Close enough. There you go. It's Perfect. So.
Yeah. Yeah, so that one will be in the store for the month, and you can buy the pattern and then get 10% off the yarn.
Yes.
If you're a 3K Club member, right?
Is yes.
It? Yeah, right.
Which is worth it because, you know, membership has its privileges.
Yeah, that's right. We're all about the perks.
Yes, we are.
We're all about the perks, about the perks, about the perks. All right, so we're going to do a short podcast today. So the only other thing I have to talk about, and maybe Cecilia has something else, I don't know. We got no education piece on here, so if you want to throw in some education really quick, go for it, girl. But the only other thing I have is to say, Kelly Peterson, you won our door prize.
Yay,
from last episode. Yay! And then this time around, we're going to be giving away a skein of Araucania Yumbrel DK. It's 100% cotton.
Nice.
And a Wool Addicts project bag. So we will have that available for somebody who comments on our blog.
Yes.
Or on our podcast, rather. Not on our blog. Blog's a different thing. I will say, we did get some good comments. Well, we got one, at least one comment, and then you can tell them about the share, about the whole Star Wars thing,
yes,
and how enjoyable that was to watch. Cecilia tried to explain to me how the Star Wars chronology works.
Yes.
Yeah. So.
Did the best I could, people. So, my husband, who watches our podcast religiously, cut out just the bit about the Star Wars, you know, thing and posted to another site that he is on where they just post random stuff. And, you know, several people liked, you know, kind of thing. And then one lady commented that she was going to go watch the rest of it. And she goes, and this is what knitters really talk about. And so it was very sweet. And I appreciate that he does that for me, you know. But he thought I did a good job. Do it again.
Well, you know, it's hard when you're working with somebody who's a little dense about that.
Yeah.
Whole thing.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
true. Yeah, you're a little dense.
About that thing.
Oh, I guess.
So, any educational stuff you want to talk about?
I check what needle size you're supposed to be using. Write it on your Ravelry page, because I didn't put it there either. It's only because I knew.
Yeah.
But
yeah, I don't think I put on my Ravelry page. I know I put the color that I'm using for this. I wonder if I actually did I start it on Ravelry? I don't know. You know, especially if that's going to be in the store, that's important so that we can go and look that up when somebody says, "Well, what size did she use?" Although we do have that on our tags now.
Yeah.
So.
But I normally put it on there. It's just
not that it really matters what size we use. You need to use the size of needle in order to get the gauge that's called for in this pattern.
Exactly.
The blocked gauge.
Blocked gauge.
And then check your gauge when you've started your project and you're up a little ways. Just go back and check to make sure that your gauge that you're getting now is the same as your unblocked gauge that you were getting when you knit your swatch, because it can change.
Depending on what's going on in your life and how long it's been,
all sorts of things. Maybe you were trying to get done with your swatch fast, and so you were a little tighter. Maybe now that you're into the project, you relaxed a little bit, and you're a little looser.
All these things make a difference. Maybe you're drinking heavily, and now you've quit. Whichever. Or you weren't drinking at all and now you've started.
Maybe you picked up the wrong needle when
Maybe
you started
you
your garment.
Exactly. That is a thing. Yes. So make sure you're using the right needle for you.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's all about you.
think this is a short video, but
we'll see.
Well, I can see right now. It says 35 minutes.
Look at us. Yay.
And I know I'm cutting out some at the beginning. Although, I might just put it in after the closing credits because it was kind of silly. So, anyway, hope to see most of you at Shop Hop.
Yes.
Those of you who are not in the Twin Cities, I'm sorry you're missing it. Wait, before we end, one more thing. We have decided to do a couple of Bring a Friend discounts on the Faina Gaberstein workshops that are coming up April 26th and on our Cloud Nine retreat. So the deal is if you sign up with a friend, then you get 5% off your class fee. Each of you gets 5% off and a special gift. We're going to give you a special gift. So keep that in mind if you have been on the fence and if you want to find a friend that wants to come with you, you get a little bonus.
That's right.
So, but you have to, it has to all be signed up for over the phone or in the store because there's no way for us to arrange the
online.
The coupon or the discount online. So sorry about that.
Yeah.
But at least you get something.
That's right.
So anyway, that's all I got. So we'll see you at the Shop Hop.
See you
or we'll
Thursday,
see you
Friday,
next podcast.
Saturday, Sunday, whenever.
Yeah. So, all right. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Such a thing that I think would be
well,
the appropriate way to do it.
Then you do it.
It's
you
okay.
If something's appropriate, you do it your way.
I'll do it my way.
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
The end is near.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
Born ready.
That whole thing should be in the outtakes.